Hello everyone, welcome to Nagesh Kalasgi Orchid School. I am Pooja Rajamane. I am your computer teacher. We studied our lesson number 5, right? In that, we studied what is meant by Windows. Windows is an operating system and these Windows having 4 main components. Which are they? Desktop, icon, then taskbar and start button. And we studied what is the use of this components. Now we will see in Windows one more the thing is WordPad. We will see about the WordPad. This is desktop, right? These are icons. What it is? Yes, loudly. What it is? Yes, taskbar. And what it is? Start button. What is the use of start button? All programs, all the software which is in our computer is displayed in start button. When we click on the start button, then all the menus will be displayed. And when we click on this arrow, then another program appear. These are called as a what? What do you call that? This menu, what do you call? I can hear you loudly. Yes, we call sub menu. It's called sub menu. Means this another list is another menus are called as a sub menu. Now we will see about the WordPad. We will see about WordPad. Firstly, we will see how to open the WordPad. How to open the WordPad? For open, for start anything, then which button we must have to click? Yes, we must have to click start button. Then click the start button, then all program, then accessories, and then WordPad. Then we will get one window. It is called as a WordPad window. How to open it? Firstly, click the start button, then all program, then accessories, and then WordPad. Then this window will be open. Now this window having a different part, which are the title bar, menu bar, then control buttons, next the ribbon, quick access toolbar and scroll bar. Now we will see where is this. What is it? It is, what is it? It is WordPad window, right? It is WordPad window. Then which different part having WordPad window? First one is a title bar. Where is the title bar? You can see here upper side, the upper side line we can see here, it is called as a title bar. Why it is called as a title bar? We will see afterwards. It is called as a title bar. Next one, you can see the three buttons, minimize button, maximize button and close button. Minimize, maximize and close, this button is called as a control button. Control buttons. These buttons are called as a control buttons. And it is a scroll bar. It is scroll bar. This is quick access toolbar. Quick access toolbar. And next one is the ribbon. The ribbon, these are called as the ribbon. The ribbon and these are control menu. Control menu is also there. Where is the control menu? These are control menu. What it? First one is a title bar. Next one, control buttons. Then scroll bar. Scroll bar. Then next one is a ribbon. And last one is a control menu. What it everyone? Where is the title bar? Where is the control buttons? This is ribbon. Scroll bar. Next one is a here. You can see here. Quick access toolbar. And these are the control menu. It is all parts of the our WordPad. Different parts of Windows are, which are the title bar, control menu, control buttons, the ribbon, quick access toolbar, scroll bars. When you start the program, a windows of the program appear of the Windows application having some common feature and commands. We have studied now only means where is the title bar, where is the control buttons, this always is the scroll bar. Now let us understand some of the feature with example of the WordPad window. Means what is the feature, what is the uses of these different parts. Means what is the use of title bar, control buttons, quick access toolbar, we will see here. First one is a title bar. Where is the title bar? Yes, the title bar is located at the top of the window, right? It is title bar, right? Now right everyone, it is title bar. Where it is? Top of the window. On the left side of the bar is displayed the name of the program and the document you are currently working on. Means it is WordPad, and it is showing here. You can see the document now, but if we save here, then it is showing what we given name and which document, currently document which we are working, it is showing on the where, on the title bar. In the right hand corner of this bar there are three buttons. What do you call that buttons? Yes, control buttons. Control buttons, you can see here, control buttons, right? Minimize, maximize and close. Now next one is clear about title bar. Next one is control buttons. How many control buttons are there? Three, right? There are three control buttons which help you to increase or decrease the size of window and also to close the window. Means what is the use of these buttons? What is the use of control buttons? There are three buttons. How many control buttons are there? Three. And these buttons having a different uses. Means by using the three buttons we can increase or decrease the size of window. Otherwise, if you don't want this window, then that time we can close also, right? Firstly, we will see about the minimize button. We will see about minimize button. What is the use of this minimize button? This button is used to reduce and hide the window to the program button on the taskbar. Means if you want, see, you can see here. See here, it is, what is it, what it is? First one is the, it is title bar, right? And where is the control buttons? These are control buttons, right? In that, what we are seeing, what we are studying now, we are studying this minimize. You can see here, when I place here one, then downside name is display. What is it? Minimize. Minimize button. If you want to minimize the window or reduce the window or hide the window to the program, then you can see here, when I press here, then it go on the where? On the taskbar. This our WordPad is here. WordPad is on taskbar. When I minimize here, then this WordPad is on our taskbar. Now, how to minimize it? Firstly, click on the minimize of the WordPad window as shown in figure. Means these are the control buttons, and when we press this minimize button, then our window will be minimized. And where it went? It is went in our, it is went on our, it is displayed on our taskbar. It is displayed on our taskbar. Right? Now this our WordPad is on taskbar. The screen appear as shown below after a minimizing. Right? We see. If you want to restore a Windows after you have minimized it, click the button on the of the window on the taskbar, the window will be appear. Means if you want to open it once again, means firstly if we minimize it, when we minimize, then this window will be stored or will be displayed in our taskbar. Right? And if you want to restore it, if you want to open it, then in that time we must have to click here. Got it about the minimize button? Now next we will see about our maximize. Mini means what? Small. And maxi is opposite to minimize. Means minimize button means what? This is the symbol of minimize button. And what is the use of this button? This button is used to increase the size of window to the full screen. This button is useful for increase the size of window. Means our window is small in size. If our window is small in size, you can see here, this is small in size, right? It is not minimized. If it is minimized, then we can see this window in taskbar. Now it is minimized? No, it is not minimized. But it is, if we want this in full page, that time we require maximize button. Where is the maximize button? This middle is the maximize button. This middle is maximize button. See here, when I click here, then what will happen? You see here, this window will appear as a full screen, right? If you don't want this window, then do the minimize. And suppose if you want to increase the size of window, that time we are using the maximize button. Okay, clear about minimize and maximize button and how to do this minimize and maximize? Now next one, control buttons. How many control buttons are there? Three. Which are they? Minimize, maximize and close. Now we will see about the close button. This is the symbol of the close button. This button is used to close. Now if I don't want this window, and then that time we will close it. Okay, what is the difference between minimize and close? If we minimize it, then it is displayed on the taskbar. But if I close it, then it is closed. Got it about the minimize, maximize and close. Now we will see next part is the control menu. Control menu. The control menu icon is on the left of the title bar. Is the left side of the title bar. When you click the icon, the submenu appear which is similar to the use of control buttons. Means control menu is same as a control button. Control menu is same as control button. And where is the control menu? Is the left of the title bar. Is the left of title bar. Now next one is the ribbon. What is the use of ribbon? It is just a bar below the title bar. It has a list of menu option like WordPad button, home menu and view menu. You will see here it is the WordPad, and where is the ribbon? Ribbon is here, right? Ribbon is here. These all called as a ribbon. First one is a, it is the WordPad button. See cursor, where is the cursor? See carefully. It is WordPad button. Next one is a home. Next one is home, and next one is view. These are the menu, and where it is? It is in the ribbon. It is in ribbon. The home menu has a various tool which you can use to perform a different action. Means what is the use of home menu? We will see here. For example, to draw a picture, you can you use various tools like a drawing paper, pencil, color and brush. Similarly, the home menu has a various tool to create, edit and print the document. We will see here what is the use of home menu. We will type here, I am student. You can see here, you can see this font are small. Suppose if I want to increase the font size, if I want to increase the font size, that time which menu I will use? I will use home menu. It is already open, home, and when we press the view, then you can see this option only. It is in home menu. And then how to increase the size? You can see here font size. When you press this arrow, this number, we can increase the font size. But if you want to do any changes in the WordPad, then that time we must have to select it. If we not select, then these changes will not happen. So we will see here. You can see? No, you can see, you cannot see any changes. But if I select it, and if I, then you can see the changes. Got it? Here is also, by using this option also, we can increase or decrease the font size. See, we can increase the font size. Suppose I want these all letters in bold, then I will use here B. I want it italic, then I will use I. I want underline, then I will use underline. Got it? Bold, italic, underline. Now if I want to change the color, if I want to change the font color, that time I will use this option, this icon you can see here, this option you can see here, not icon, these colors, which color we want, we can take this color. Okay, we will take red color. Got it? Bold, italic, underline and bold color. If we want background color, then we can give background color also. Okay. If I want to go next time, next line, then which key? Which key I will use? Or which key we will use? Yes, we will use enter key. We will use enter key. I like school. If we don't want this, then we can I like school. I am in third standard. I am in third standard. Okay, now what it all we can save also. Where we can save? Which option is useful to save? Yes, it is which button? It is WordPad button. When we click on WordPad button, then downside menu will be appear. Which menu? New, open, save, save as. Right? What we have to do now? What do you want now? We want to save this file. Then click here. Then this type of window will be appear. Where we want to save it? We want to save it on the desktop. And we will give your name third and lesson number fifth. Third, lesson number fifth. And afterwards when we give name, then click save. You can see here third 5. What name we given? It display upper side, right? It display upper side. That's why it is called as a title bar. That's why it is called as a title bar. Got it? Use of the ribbon means in home. Home, by using that home button, we can change the font color, font size, and font style also we can change. Here is the font styles. See the changes? You can see the difference? Which effect I give here? Font, I change the font style. And in view. Means if you want to zoom in, zoom out, that time we are using the view. Ruler, status bar, it is also in view button. Got it about the WordPad button, home button and view. Means in ribbon, there are the three buttons, three options are there. Which are they? WordPad button, home menu and view menu. What is the use of home menu, understand? If you want to write, if you want to give font effect, and if you want to underline it, if you want to do anything on the font, that time you are using the home button. If you want to save the file, or otherwise if you want to print the pages, that time we are using the which button? WordPad button. We are using WordPad button. And what is mean by what is the use of view? If you want to zoom in or zoom out, that time we are using the view option. Next one is a quick access toolbar. What is mean by quick access toolbar? Firstly, we will read. Here is the quick access toolbar. This bar is located on the topmost left side of the window. Some of the most important buttons are save, undo, redo. You can add buttons like a new, open, print or remove any of the existing ones. We will see here what is the use of quick access toolbar. Quick access toolbar, you can see here what is the symbol. Which symbol it is? It is the symbol of save. It is mean by undo. It is mean by redo. Save, undo, redo. And one line and this triangle you can see here, it is called as a quick access toolbar. When I click this quick access toolbar, then what you want? Means if you want to save option upper side, then we can add this type of option. Which options are there? New, open, save is already because it is a symbol of save. Next, undo, redo is also there, and we can send an email. These are the options, and if we click here, then you can see the changes. See here concentratedly. If I do like that, then you understand. This one document or this picture you can see here, it is called as a new. If you want to take a new document, then that time it is useful. If you want to open from here, then it is folder, it is for opening. And suppose if you don't want this, then we can remove it also. How to remove? Click on the quick access toolbar and click here only, then it is wet. Got it? What is the use of quick access toolbar? If you want to add this option in quickly side, that time we are using the quick access toolbar. Now last one is scroll bar. What is the use of scroll bar? Sometimes a work area does not fit in a computer. Work area does not fit in a computer screen, and you cannot see the entire text of the document. The scroll bar help you to view the entire work. You can see this here only. See there, this font is big, right? That's why I have to adjust this font. If it is like that, then you can see the fonts from here. No, you cannot see. Then I have to adjust this, then you can see here, then you can see, and you can see here one more scroll bar is also there for up and down. Means how many scroll bars are there? Two scroll bars are there. You can see here this, and these are scroll bar. This one and this one is scroll bar, right? First one scroll bar is vertical scroll bar. Scroll bars are two types, which are the vertical scroll bar and horizontal scroll bar. What is meant by vertical scroll bar? The vertical scroll bar is the right side of the window which allows you to move the text or information up or down. It is vertical scroll bar. It is vertical scroll bar. If our text is up and down format, or if you want to move the cursor from up down, that time we are using the vertical scroll bar. Now next one is a horizontal scroll bar. The bar is the bottom of the window. You can see here. It is bottom of the window. This bar is at the bottom of the window, which allows you to move the content towards the left or right on the screen. If you want to move the tape, if you want to move the content towards the left or right side, that time we are using the horizontal scroll bar. Got it? Left or right, that time we are using horizontal scroll bar. If you want to move to the up or down side, that time we are using the which scroll bar? Yes, vertical scroll bar. What is the homework? You must have to read all the lesson number 5 and underline the hard words. Thank you.